Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, good morning, sir.
Did you all cover the revaluation of assets adjustment in the last lecture?
Yes, sir.
Did you all try with? Can you all see the question on the screen? Question number 18.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, be attentive. Prateek Varu from Nizampura. Unmute yourself. Prateek Varu from Nizampura. Prateek Varu from Nizampura. Unmute yourself. Your video is also off and you are not able to unmute yourself also. Bhumi, read the question.
Following are the assets and liabilities of S Limited and it is 31st March 2019.
Just a minute.
Goodwill 38,000 H Limited.
Just one minute. Make it H Limited and S Limited. All of you make the correction. Make it H Limited and S Limited. Instead of S Limited and A Limited, make in the question H Limited and S Limited. Okay? Yes, further.
Also, it's Goodwill H Limited 38,000.
Now, all of you can see one thing over here, that proper balance sheet is not given. Therefore, they have not given the heading following are the balance sheet. What is the heading given following are the assets and
liabilities?
So, proper balance sheet is not given. Therefore, you find first assets information is given, then liabilities information is given. But we can consider it similar to balance sheet. Okay. Now, goodwill is already given in the question. So, raise your hand. Which three things are possible? Goodwill is already given in the question. So, raise your hand. Which three things are possible? Deepa? Deepa?
Sir, first option is we have to, if goodwill is there in working note 5, then we have to add in goodwill. Second option, if there is goodwill more than capital reserve, then we have to minus from goodwill capital reserve. And if capital reserve is more, then we have to plus in capital reserve.
Then goodwill we have minus
in capital reserve.
Very good. Correct. Is everyone clear with the 3 points? First thing, in our control chart B, if we also get goodwill, then we will add in this goodwill. If in our control chart B, we get capital reserve and capital reserve is less than 38,000, then we will minus capital reserve from goodwill. If in control chart B, we get capital reserve, which is more than 38,000, then goodwill we will minus from capital reserve. I told you the shortcut is bigger amount minus smaller amount. Is every one of you clear with this concept of goodwill? Any doubt in that?
No.
No, sir.
No.
Clear with that, sir. Right? Okay, goodwill will come in intangible fixed assets. Okay. Yes, Bhumi did it further.
Machinery, H Limited 3 lakh, S Limited 2 lakh 61,000.
Where will machinery come?
Tangible fixed assets.
Tangible fixed assets. Machinery and furniture both. Further?
Stock 40,000, 60,000.
Where will stock come?
Inventories,
and all this will get consolidated. Okay, means added. Then,
debtors 37,000, 98,000.
Where will debtors come?
Trade receivable.
So you all can see that information is not in proper order. Also, when we write it in the balance sheet, we have to write it in the proper order. Further,
bank 50,000, 61,000.
Bank will come under
cash and cash equivalent.
Cash and cash equivalents. Further?
Investment, 4,50,000, 79,000.
Where will investments come?
Non-current
investment.
Non-current investments. And can I say this entire 4,50,000 is in subsidiary company?
No.
No, because it is not mentioned investment in shares of subsidiary company. So investments we will have to divide in two parts. One is in the shares of subsidiary company and the other is Bhumi, the other part. Outside investments.
Outside.
Only S Limited investments will get cancelled, which we'll see from the adjustments. Outside investments and 79,000 will continue to appear in non-current investments. Okay. Is everyone clear with the point of investments?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Everyone mute yourselves. Yes, Bhumi, further.
Bills receivable, 35,000, 45,000.
Where will bills receivable come?
Trade receivable.
Yes, so debtors and bills receivable both will come under the category of trade receivables. Further?
Liabilities, equity shares capital of rupees 10 each, 6 lakh, 4 lakh.
So how many equity shares in H Limited?
60,000.
6 lakhs divided by 10, 60,000 and?
40,000.
4 lakhs divided by 10, 40,000. What will we do with this 4 lakhs of S Limited?
Cancel it.
It will not come in consolidated balance sheet. And this will come in share capital. Further?
Security premium, 96,000.
Then?
General reserve, 84,000, 55,000.
Further?
Profit and loss account, 2 lakh, 1 lakh.
Where will these three things come?
Reserve and surplus.
Reserves and surplus. And which amounts will get cancelled?
S Limited.
55,000 and 1 lakh of S Limited will get cancelled. It will not come in consolidated balance sheet. Further?
Creditors, 25,000, 35,000.
That will appear in?
Trade payable.
Creditors will appear in trade payable. Then?
Term loan.
95,000,
60,000.
It will appear in?
Long-term borrowings.
Yes, long-term borrowings. And?
Bills payable, 30,000.
That will come in?
Trade payables.
Very good. So, is everyone clear with the information given in the balance sheet? Any doubt in that?
No, sir.
Okay, mute yourselves. Now, contingent liability for bills discounted 4,000 and 6,000. So if there is any intercompany adjustment, then simply single effect will come in contingent liability. We just have to eliminate and minus it from contingent liability. Yes, Bhumi, read adjustment 1.
H Limited acquired 32,000 equity shares on 1/10/18 in S Limited a premium of rupees 4 per share.
What will we get from 32,000 equity shares, Bhumi? Working note 1, degree of control. What will you get from 1/10/18?
Date of acquisition
means in working note 2, we will get time ratio. And at a premium of rupees 4, so what will we get from this? Anyone else? Premium of rupees 4, what will we get from this? Raise your hand. Premium of rupees 4, what will we get from this? Abhishek Rawal.
Investment, sir.
How will we find the amount of investments in subsidiary company? Yes, Abhishek, it's correct. How will we find the investments amount? You are not audible, Abhishek. Hey, Shah, Subhangura, how will we find investments amount?
Sir, the premium is 14 and the share is of rupees 10. So 32,000 into 14.
Yes, premium of 4 rupees means 10 plus 4. We have acquired at 14 rupees. So 32,000 into 14. 32,000 shares are acquired. What is 32,000 into 14? 4,48,000. Now, hey, in what two
yes,
parts
sir.
We will divide this 4,50,000?
Sir, S Limited 4,48,000 and other investment of ₹2,000.
Yes, S Limited 4,48,000, outside investments 2,000. This 4,48,000 gets cancelled. 2,000 and 79,000 will continue to appear in the balance sheet. Okay. Is everyone of you clear with the first adjustment? Any doubts in that?
No, sir.
Hello,
sir. Investment cash value when I check on the
issue. Just a minute. Yes, unmute yourself again and ask it.
Sir, investment face value पे नहीं चेक करने के?
Never. We are buying at a premium of rupees 4 na. So we are investing, holding company is investing what amount in the subsidiary company? 32,000 into 14. Okay?
Yes.
And that's
yes.
why we have goodwill and capital reserve. If you acquire at face value only, then there will be no goodwill and capital reserve ever.
Yes, sir.
When does goodwill or capital reserve arise? When you either pay more or you pay less.
Less.
Okay? So you always have to consider including premium or excluding discount if it is given in the question. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Any other doubts in adjustment one? Raise your hand. Okay. Bhumi, unmute and read the next adjustment.
S Limited had following balance as on 1st April 2018. General reserve ₹30,000. Profit and loss account ₹50,000.
Yes. 1,418 means it is?
Opening balance.
So this will help us in working note 4. Now working note 4 because revaluation will also be there. So P&L and general reserve will come in working note 4. Yes, further.
4. Value of machinery and furniture as on 31st March 19 are after charging depreciation for 2018-19 at 10% per annum and 5% per annum respectively on book value as on 1st April 2018.
Now question 16 and 17, what we had done? In that question, was rate of depreciation given? Yes or no?
12%.
In the question
no.
16 and 17, was the rate of
no.
depreciation given in the question?
No. Sir.
What was
no,
given
sir.
In the question?
Opening and closing balance.
Yes, Pooja, very good. Opening and closing balances. Opening book value was given. Closing is available from the balance sheet. We found the difference amount as depreciation and from that we obtained the rate of depreciation. Can you all recollect it or not? In question 16, 17. But in this question, opening value is not given. Rate of depreciation is given. So we have to find the opening value. Now tell me in balance sheet, what is the value of machinery of S Limited? All of you, what is the value of machinery in the balance sheet of S Limited?
261,000.
What is the rate of depreciation on machinery adjustment 3?
10%.
Raise your hand. How can you find the opening value? Because without opening value, we cannot make the workings of revaluation. Do you understand the difference in 16-17 than this question? In 16-17 question, opening value was given and we found the rate of depreciation. In this question, rate of depreciation is given and we have to find the opening value. Now, how can you find the opening value? Because without that, we cannot even start with our working note of revaluation of assets. How will you find the opening value of machinery? I'm asking you. Raise your hand. Very simple it is. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Don't answer directly, please. Raise your hand. Anyone else other than Deepa? How can you find the opening value of plant and machinery? Manav Patel, Pratap Nagar.
10% depreciation add kar denge.
Kaise karenge batao? 4,51,000 hai to.
4 lakh?
4,51,000 is the value na? In balance sheet. What is the value of plant and machinery?
2,61,000.
Sorry, 2,61,000. So how will you find the opening value?
Sir, 2,61,000 into 10 divided by 100.
2,61,000 into?
into 10 divided by 90.
261,000 into 10 divided by 90. Do it. What do you get?
इसमें जो ये वैल्यू है वो प्लस कर देंगे.
29,000 is the depreciation that you will add it. Very good. And how did you get this 10 by 90?
Sir, क्योंकि जब opening cost होगा उसमें 90 plus तब 100 होगा ना उसलिए.
Correct. All of you be attentive. He is right. How will we find the opening value? Understand this. See, suppose the value in the beginning is 100. What is the rate of depreciation on plant and machinery? All of you?
10%.
What will be the value at the end of the year?
90.
What is the value at the end of the year already given in the question? 261,000. So what will be the value at the beginning of the year? 261,000 into 100 divided by 90. Okay, 261,000 into 100 divided by 90. Do you all get 290,000 or not?
Yes.
Now cross check, what is 290,000 10% depreciation? 29,000 to 290,000 minus 29,000. Do you get the value at the end, 261,000 or not?
Yes, sir.
So did every one of you understand how to find the opening value from the rate of depreciation? Did all of you understand how to find the opening value from the rate of depreciation?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Raise your hand who did not understand this. Because I'll ask you for furniture. Any one of you, I'll unmute and ask for furniture. So raise your hand who did not understand this opening value of machinery how to get. Everyone is clear with opening value of machinery, sure? Vaishali Ja, Nizampura, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Now, Vaishali, what is the value of furniture in the balance sheet?
76,000.
What is the rate of depreciation on furniture?
5%.
Tell me, how will we do this working for furniture?
Hundred minus five, we will get ninety-five.
Then, where should I write this 76,000? Where should I write 76,000, Vaishali? In front of which value should I write 76,000? Vaishali, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So where should I write 76,000? The value in the balance sheet is after depreciation or not, Vaishali?
Yes, sir.
So here, which is the value after depreciation, 100 or 95?
100.
100 is before depreciation.
Oh, 95.
So where should I write 76,000? Should I write it against 100 or should I write it against 95?
95.
Yes. Did you understand?
Yes.
So how will you find the value in the beginning?
Oh, 76,000 into 100 divided by 95.
Yes, now you understood it?
Yes.
Okay, so why you did not raise
80,000?
Why you did not raise hand if you did not understand it earlier? Without fail, you must ask your doubts, okay? 80,000 is correct. Very good. So this is how we get the opening value, which was given in the question 16 and 17, but not given here. All of you are clear with the opening values? Any doubts in this?
No, sir.
Sure, everyone is clear. Anyone who wants me to explain again how to find the opening value?
No, sir. We'll be showing proper
structured workings. Again, this was just to explain you, okay? In the solution of working notes, we'll be showing this. Don't worry about that. Bhumi, please unmute and read the further part.
Stock of H Limited includes goods or rupees 30,000 sold by S Limited on one.
Four, you forgot. Bhumi, adjustment four.
Yes, yes. H Limited revalued asset of S Limited on the date of acquisition as follow, for which no effect has been given. Machinery rupees 3 lakh and furniture rupees 70,000.
Now, what is the date of acquisition?
110.18.
So H Limited has revalued machinery of 3 lakhs on which date 110.18, and also furniture of 70,000 on which date 110.18.
Yes.
Can I say 3 lakhs against 2,61,000? Sorry, 2,90,000 means there is a revaluation profit of 10,000. Can I say that?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Against 2,90,000, machinery is revalued at 3,02,000. So can I say there is a profit of 10,000? It is revalued upward by 10,000. Can I say that?
No.
Pooja Maheshwari?
No. No.
Why?
No, sir. Because that value is not on the date of acquisition of shares. That is at the end of the year.
Correct. Very good. Manav, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
2,90,000 is the value on which day?
1,4,18.
1,4,18. And 3 lakh revaluation is done on which day?
1,10,18.
How can you compare the value on 1,4,18 with 1,10,18? You cannot. 3 lakhs cannot be compared with 2,90,000. We'll have to make the workings and first find the value of asset on 1,10,18. Then only we can compare it with 3 lakhs and we can say valued upward or downward. Did you all understand why we cannot directly compare, but we'll have to first make the workings and find the value on the date of acquisition? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Same way, we cannot compare 70,000 directly with 80,000 and say there is a revaluation loss of 10,000. Because 80,000 is the value on which date?
1,4,18.
And 70,000 is revalued on which date?
1,10,18.
So first we'll have to find the value of furniture on 1,10,18. Then only comparison can be done and we can find as it revalued upward or revalued downward. Okay. So that workings will have to be made. Is everyone clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Comparison can be done only when the shares are acquired on 1,4,18, beginning of the year. Then you can directly compare the values and find the revalued upward or downward amount. But here the shares are acquired on 1,10,18. Okay, Bhumi, read the adjustment file.
Stock of H Limited.
Unmute and read it now because there was a lot of noise in between.
Stock of H Limited includes goods or rupees of rupees 30,000 sold by S Limited on 1st February 2019 at profit of 20% on a cost.
Now, all of you tell me, first of all, what will we do with this 30,000? What two effects will we give for 30,000?
Minus from debtors and creditors.
This is what we don't have to do. No, just a minute. No effect is to be given for 30,000. Pooja?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Stock includes 30,000. Is it mentioned included in debtors?
But it is written sold.
Is it written sold on credit?
No.
They may have sold on cash also.
Mm.
Okay. If you refer to the past questions, what we have done. Okay. If you refer to the past questions, what we have done. Like question 16, if I say. Then read this adjustment 3.
Creditors of S Limited.
Creditors of S Limited include. Is it mentioned creditors include or not?
Yes.
That means it is purchased on credit. Okay. Whereas here it is mentioned stock includes. Stock includes means it is remaining unsold. That's it. Stock includes means entire stock is remaining unsold. You understand that?
Yes.
Okay. So all of you be careful. Every time unrealized profit does not mean that we have to minus from debtors as well as creditors. When do we have to minus from debtors and creditors also? When it is mentioned that it is included in debtors or included in creditors, or it is mentioned that it is sold on credit. Either it will be mentioned it is included in debtors and creditors, or it will be mentioned that it is sold on credit. Is that clear to everyone? Here,
yes, sir.
Here stock yes, includes sir. Indicates what? Stock includes indicates what over here?
Unsold.
Yes, unsold. The goods are remaining unsold. That's it. All goods are remaining unsold. Stock includes means the goods are remaining unsold. Okay. Now tell me, sold by S Limited. First of all, we'll get unrealized profit from this adjustment. Sold by S Limited. So is it downstream sale or upstream sale?
Upstream.
Upstream. Upstream
sale, because child is selling to the parent. Sold by S Limited means subsidiary is selling to holding company. So it is upstream sale. Is further we have to take holding company's share. And what did I tell you? The shortcut 20% on cost means you'll do 20 by
120.
Very good. If it is on selling price, here it is opposite than 11, 12 standard and FSY, what we used to do. Earlier on selling price, we used to do 20 by 120. But here on selling price means you'll do 20 by 100. On cost price means you will do 20
by 120.
How will you find unrealized profit? 10,000 into 20 by 120. Do that. 10,000 into 20 divided by 120. What do you all get?
1667.
1667. You get it? And further in that, because it is upstream sale, we will have to find holding company's share. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
What two effects will be for unrealized profit?
I repeat.
What two effects? What two effects will you give for unrealized profit?
Minus from stock and minus from profit and
PN.
Yes, minus from stock and PN.
Stock.
Put tick on stock. Put tick on stock and put tick on PNL account. We will minus from stock and minus from PNL account. Okay. Then. Yes, Bhumi adjustment 6.
Sorry, repeat once.
Manav, unrealized profit, what two effects we have to give? Minus from PNL account and minus from stock.
Sir, that 10,000 value.
Sorry, not 10,000, 30,000. I'm sorry. All of you do 30,000 into 20 by 120.
5,000
into holding company's share, you'll minus from stock and minus from PNL amount. Okay? Is that clear, Manav?
Yes, sir.
Is every one of you clear with unrealized profits adjustment? Any doubt in it?
No, sir.
Yes, Bhumi, unmute and read adjustment 6.
Bills receivable of H Limited include rupees 4,000 accepted by S Limited.
What will you do with this 4,000?
Intercompany adjustment.
So what two effects we will give for this 4,000? What two effects will we give for this 4,000?
Bills receivable and bills payable.
Correct. Minus from bills receivable and minus from bills payable. All of you put tick on bills receivable and bills payable. Further.
Contingent liability of rupees 4,000 for bills discounted as shown in the balance sheet of H Limited related to bills accepted by S Limited.
This is also intercompany adjustment, but when it comes in contingent liability, only one effect. From this 4,000, we have to minus intercompany 4,000. That's it. Is everyone clear with this? In contingent liability, only one effect is to be given, simply minus from contingent liability. Yeah. Anyone having any doubt in that?
No, sir.
So now prepare consolidated balance sheet of S Limited and its subsidiary S Limited as at 31/3/19. What will we be doing in the live classes only?
Working.
Only workings will we do right now, and then I'll discuss the items of balance sheet orally, and you'll complete the things orally on your, at home on your, and solution I'll show it to you, so you can verify whether it is right or not. Okay? Chalo, let's start with the workings. working note 1. Heta Patel from OP Road, unmute yourself. Heta Patel from OP Road.
Yes, sir.
Tell me working note 1.
Degree of control.
All of you write down degree of control. Which two columns will come?
H limited and my.
H limited and minority interest. Yes, further in degree of control, what should I write?
Equity share.
How many equity shares?
32,000.
40,000 are there. Presently,
40,000.
So you will write 40,000 equity shares of S Limited. Okay, you will write 40,000 equity shares of S
Limited.
Now in H Limited's column, what you will write?
32,000.
32,000 are acquired by H Limited. All of you can see in adjustment number 1. And how many are with minority shareholders?
8,000.
8,000. So what is the ratio of degree of control? Both are divisible by 8.
Yes.
4:1.
4:1. 32 divided by 8 is 4. 8 divided by 8 is 1. So 4:1. 4 by 5 and 1 by 5 is the ratio of degree of control. Okay. Is everyone clear with working note 1? Any doubt in this?
Yes. No, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Rahul Tolani from Pratap Nagar, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Second working note.
Time ratio.
Time ratio. Yes, tell me how will we find the time ratio? Which 3 dates should I write?
Date of beginning of the year.
What is 1/4 that?
18. 1/4/18.
Date of beginning of the year 1/4/18 then?
Date of acquisition 1/10/18.
Date of acquisition, all of you can see in adjustment 1 is 1/10/18.
And date of ending of the year 31/3/19.
Date of year ending 31/3/19. So pre-acquisition period is?
6 months.
6 months and post-acquisition period is again?
Also 6 months.
6 months. So what is the time ratio?
1:1.
1:1. 1/2 and 1/2. Yes. Now every one of you tell me third working will be of which working note?
Profit and
revaluation of machinery.
Evaluation of assets, okay? Now I am doing the workings of machinery on the screen and all of you will try the workings of furniture on your own.
Yes.
Okay? I am doing for machinery on the screen and all of you will try. Will you all try furniture on your own or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Doing it for machinery first. First, we find the value of machinery in the beginning of the year. So all of you have done, suppose on 1/4/18, the book value of machinery is equal to 100. Minus depreciation. What is the rate of depreciation?
10%.
10. So on 31/3/19, what is the book value of machinery?
19.
Now in balance sheet, what is the book value of machinery?
2,61,000.
That 2,61,000 is on 31/3/19. So what would be the value in the beginning of the year? 2,61,000 into 100 divided by 90. That comes to 2,90,000.
Yes, sir.
Did you all understand this calculation as I explained while discussing the question also? Now what 4 columns do we have to make first? Particulars. What 4 columns? Particulars then?
Book value, revaluation, and effect.
Book value, then?
Revaluation.
Revaluation, and then last column?
Effect.
Effect.
All of you make 4 columns, particulars, book value, revaluation, and effects. Now, we will start with the value on which date?
1/4/18.
1418. What value did we get for machinery on 1418? Yes. 2,90,000. We got the value of machinery on 1418. Any doubt in that? Okay. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, on which date the shares are acquired?
1-10-18.
So first we will find depreciation up to 1-10-18.
Yes, sir.
That is how many months?
6 months.
6 months.
6 months. And what is the rate of depreciation?
10%.
10%.
So 2,90,000 into 10% into 6 by 12.
14,500.
So 2,90,000 minus 14,500. What is the value of machines in 1,10,18?
2,75,500.
This is the value as on 1,10,18. Now, can you compare this value with the value of 3 lakhs or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because
yes,
3 lakhs was also on 1,10,18. So can these two values be compared or not?
Yes, sir.
So against this, if you write 3 lakhs, then actually revaluation upward is how much?
10.
How much revaluation upward is taking place?
24,500.
Okay. This difference of 24,500 is revaluation upward. What two effects will you give for this revaluation upward?
In machinery plus
and in pre-acquisition.
Plus in machinery and plus in pre-acquisition column in the next working. Okay. Now further you minus depreciation up to which date?
1,3,8,19.
Now tell me, in the book value column, will you count depreciation of 2,75,500 or 2,90,000?
2,90,000.
2,90,000, because in the books of accounts, you always provide depreciation on which value in the beginning of the year. So again, remaining 6 months, 2,90,000. Into 10% into 6 by 12 will be same 14,500.
Yeah.
Whereas on this column of revaluation, you'll calculate depreciation on 3 lakhs. What is 3 lakhs into 10% into 6 by 12? 15,000. So how much more depreciation we have to provide?
500.
And I told you the shortcut. If revaluation upward you plus, then it's depreciation. What will you do? If revaluation
minus
upward is plus, then it's depreciation.
Minus.
Minus from machinery and minus from?
Post acquisition.
Depreciation is always provided on 31st March, last day of the year. So you'll always minus it from post acquisition column. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, after the depreciation, you can see 2,61,000 is the value in balance sheet. But in our balance sheet, what will come is 3 lakh minus 15,000, 2,85,000. This is the value still right now in the consolidated balance sheet. 2,85,000. In the current balance sheet, it's 2,61,000. But in the consolidated balance sheet, we will write 2,85,000 of subsidiary account. Did you all understand this?
Yes, sir.
Now, do the same workings for furniture on your own, everyone. Fast. Okay, I'm showing the workings now. Check it, everyone. Be attentive. See, first of all, do you all get this value of furniture, 80,000 in the beginning of the year, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Those who could not get it, do it fast. Suppose on 1,418, the book value is 100 minus depreciation, rate in furniture is 5. So on 31,319, the book value will be 95,000. In balance sheet, the value of furniture is 76,000. So what will be the value in the beginning of the year? 76,000 into 100 divided by 95, that comes to 80,000. Now value on 1,418 is 80,000. If you provide depreciation up to 1,10,18, Then 80,000 into 5% into 6 by 12?
2,000.
Yes, 2,000. So what is the value on 110, 18, 80,000 minus 2,000?
78,000.
78,000. Against that, 78,000, it is revalued at what amount?
70,000.
70,000. You all can see it is revalued at 70,000. Means here it is revaluation upward or downward?
Downward.
Downward. Okay, how much revaluation downward?
8,000.
8,000 is revaluation downwards.
Downward.
So you will minus from furniture and minus from pre. Now, how will you count the depreciation in book value on 80,000 or 78,000? We'll always count the book depreciation in the book value.
80,000.
So 80,000 into 5% into remaining 6 months, 6 by 12, that is 80,000. Whereas in revaluation column, you'll count on 70,000 into 5% into 6 by 12, that comes to 1750.
1750.
So here, what is the difference? 2000 and 1750?
250.
Now, revaluation downwards you minus, so it's depreciation you will?
Plus.
Plus. You will plus in furniture and you will plus in post-acquisition profits. Okay? And what is the value of furniture in the balance sheet? 76,000.
76,000.
When we make
68,250.
We will show 68,250. Okay? Who all could get this correct? Many of you have written this in the message, your answers are correct. Okay. So is everyone of you clear with the workings of revaluation? Any doubt in that?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Now we will make working note of general reserve and P&L account. So working note 4 we will make for profit and loss account. All of you give the heading profit and loss account. What all columns will we make?
Total,
pre and post. Okay. Pooja Maheshwari, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me the workings of P&L account.
Opening balance.
Opening balance. How much is opening balance of P&L account?
50,000.
Adjustment to, all of you can see opening balance is 50,000. Where all should I write it?
Pre column.
Total and pre column. Further?
Transfer during the year. Profit during the year.
How will we find profit during the year?
Closing minus opening.
Closing minus opening.
So 1 lakh minus.
Yes, all of you can see in balance sheet of estimated
1 lakh minus
closing balance. So 1 lakh minus opening balance 50,000. So what profit in the year is 50,000. Further, how will you distribute it pre and post?
25,000, 25,000.
Yes, time ratio is 1:1. So 25,000 will come in pre column and 25,000 will come in post column. What else?
Minus downward.
Yes. First, let us give effect of revaluation of machinery and depreciation. Okay. Here we have to give revaluation effects, revaluation of machinery and its depreciation. What should I do with the effects of these two things, evaluation of machinery and its depreciation?
8,000 minus and 250 plus.
In case of machinery, I'm talking about. So 24,500 you have to plus.
Okay.
500 you have to minus in post. Okay.
Minus.
For machinery in pre-column, all of you add 24,500. And 500 you all will minus in post column. Is everyone clear with these two effects? Plus 24,500 in pre and 500 you'll minus from post. And now same way, what will be the effects of revaluation of furniture and its depreciation?
into minus in pre column and its depreciation add in post column.
Yes, 8,000 we will minus in pre column and its depreciation of 250 we will add in post column. Is every one of you clear with these things? Any doubts in it?
No, sir.
No.
No, sir. No, sir.
Now, the total capital profits or pre-acquisition profits will come to 50,000 plus 25,000 plus 24,500 minus 8,000. So does that come to 91,500, everyone?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 25,000 minus 500 plus 250, that comes to 24,750. Okay. Now exactly same way, all of you, we will make the workings of general reserve. Total, pre and post. Now all of you tell me, what is the opening balance of general reserve?
30,000.
Yes, in the adjustment number 2, all of you can see that opening balance of general reserve is 30,000. Wherever there is noise in the background, keep yourself muted. So 30,000 will come in total and pre column. How will we find transfer during the year?
Opening closing minus opening.
Closing minus opening. What is closing balance of general reserve of S Limited?
55,000
minus opening balance is
30,000.
So what is transferred to general reserve during the year?
25,000.
1:1 ratio. 12,500 is pre and 12,500 is post. So 42,500 is pre and 12,500 is post. So is every one of you clear with the workings of P&L and general reserve? Any doubts in that?
No.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Now we make the workings of control chart A.
A.
Okay, working note 5 would be control chart A. What three columns do we have to make in control chart A?
Total.
Total.
H limited and minority.
H limited and minority.
Minority.
Total H limited and minority interest. H limited will go in the ratio of 4/5 and minority interest will go in the ratio of 1/5. You all can see that ratio in the beginning, 4:1. Okay. Now, what is the first thing that comes in control chart A?
Capital profit.
Capital profits. Okay. A is capital profits. In that, two things will come first.
Acquisition.
Pre-acquisition profit.
Pre-acquisition reserve.
Pre-acquisition profits from working note 4 are 91,500. And then pre-acquisition reserves. What are pre-acquisition reserves from working
note 4? 42,500.
42,500. So 91,500 plus 42,500. That comes to 1,34,000. Okay. Now 1,34,000 into 1/5 is 26,800 and 4/5 is 1,07,200. Do you all get these amounts? Now, what is the B information we will write?
Profit.
Revenue profits. So, in that post
acquisition profit.
What are the post acquisition profits we get from working note
24,750.
You all can see here 24,750 are post acquisition profits. And what are the post acquisition reserves we get?
12,500.
post acquisition reserves from working note 4 are
12,500.
12,500. 24,750 plus 12,500 is 37,250. Okay. Now 37,250 into 4 by 5 and 1 by 5 would be 7,450 in minority interest and 29,800 in holding company.
Yes, sir.
And what is the last item we write in control chart? A?
Share capital.
Share capital of?
S Limited.
What is the share capital of S Limited in the balance sheet?
4 lakhs.
40,000 is the number of shares. What is the share capital amount? 4 lakhs. Now 4 lakhs into 4 by 5 is 3,20,000. And 1 by 5 is 80,000. So what is the total minority interest we get? 26,800 plus 7,450 plus 80,000. We all get 114,250 as minority interest.
Yes, sir.
Okay, minority interest is 114,250. Now tell me, what will you do with this first and third amount of H Limited column? 1,07,200 and 3,20,000.
Less in control chart B.
Minus in control chart B. And what will you do with this middle amount of 29,800?
Add in profit and loss account.
Add in P&L account in consolidated
balance sheet.
So all of you are confident with this?
Yes.
Now working note 6 is control chart B, that is cost of control. Okay, control chart B, that is cost of control. Yes, how do we start in control chart B, cost of control?
Investment of H Limited.
Investments of H Limited.
Into shares of.
In the shares of S
Limited.
Okay, investments of H Limited in the shares of S Limited is how much?
4,48,000.
We counted this 32,000 into 14, 4,48,000. 32,000 and then they have acquired a premium of 4 rupees. So 32,000 into 14, 4,48,000. Now from that first, what will be minus?
Value of share held by S Limited.
H Limited. What are the face value of shares held by H Limited?
3,20,000.
3,20,000. And then we have minus share of H Limited in?
Capital profit.
Capital profits of S Limited. Share of H Limited in capital profits of S Limited is how much? This first amount?
1,07,200.
1,07,200. I hope everyone is able to cope up with the speed. Okay. 3,20,000 plus 1,07,200. What amount we have minus? 4,27,200. 4,48,000 minus 4,27,200. So positive amount of 20,800. Positive means, is it goodwill or capital reserve?
Goodwill.
So you'll simply add it in goodwill given in the balance sheet in intangible fixed assets.
Yes.
Okay. Then further.
Unrealized profit
workings. Working note 7, unrealized profit. Okay, unrealized profits. First, we write goods sold by whom to whom?
S Limited to H Limited
in bracket upstream sale. What is the value of goods sold by S Limited to H Limited given in adjustment number 4?
30,000.
In fact, 5,30,000. You all can see that. And secondly, right, information of goods remaining. Goods remaining.
Unsold.
Unsold. Here, when they say stock includes, means all 30,000 of goods are remaining unsold.
Yes.
And what information of profit is given?
20% at cost price.
20% on cost price. So how will you find unrealized profit? Okay, directly shortcut method now. 30,000 are goods remaining unsold into 20% cost price. So 20 upon
120.
And because it is upstream sale, further we will do holding company's share, that is
4 by 5.
Because it is upstream sale, further we will do 4 by 5. So all of you do 30,000 into 20 by 120 into 4 by 5. Is that 4,000?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
4,000 we will minus from P&L account and minus from stock. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Is this clear to everyone? Shall I discuss with the balance sheet, which you will complete on your own later on?
Yes.
Okay, let's discuss with the balance sheet. Very first note will be of share capital. What will come in share capital?
Only 60,000. 6 lakh.
S Limited gets cancelled. So since authorized capital question mark and then issued subsequent paid up capital 60,000 shares of rupees 10 each, 6 lakhs. Is that clear for everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Next, reserves and surplus. Security premium of 96,000 as it is. Okay. Got it, everyone?
Yes.
Then general reserve 84,000 directly in outer column. Okay.
Yes.
Now profit and loss account 2 lakhs in inner column. What effects will you give in this P&L account of 2 lakhs? What if I take this P&L account of 2 lakhs? All of you, what effects will you give in P&L account?
Plus 29,800.
Plus this 29,800.
29,800.
In revenue profits of S Limited. And further?
Minus 4,000.
Minus this 4,000 unrealized profit. I repeat. Okay, I repeat, P&L account 2 lakhs plus 29,800 minus plus this 29,800 minus this 4,000. Is that clear to everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then next working will be long-term borrowings. Simply 95,000 plus 60,000. Okay. Then next working will be trade payables. Simply creditors 25,000 plus 35,000, there is no intercompany adjustment. But bills payable, there is an intercompany adjustment. So nil plus 30,000 minus what intercompany?
4,000.
Minus 4,000.
4,000.
I repeat, nil plus 30,000 minus 4,000. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
Then tangible fixed assets. Now, machinery 3 lakhs plus 2,61,000, and in that further you will plus what amount? 24,500. And further you will minus what amount?
500.
Okay.
The appreciation 500.
Same way in furniture 1,50,000 plus 76,000. Further from that you will minus
8,000
revaluation downwards, and you'll
8,000
depreciation of 250. Okay, is everyone clear with this tangible fixed assets effects?
Yes, sir.
Next note will be intangible fixed assets, goodwill 38,000 plus 20,800. Okay, goodwill will be 38,000 plus 20,800. Then non-current investments, 2,000 plus 79,000. Okay, non-current investments 2000 plus 79,000. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Inventories stock 40,000 plus 50,000. And what will you minus from stock?
Realized profit.
Unrealized
profit of 4,000. Okay, that you will minus from stock. Then cash and cash equivalent, sorry, trade receivables. Debtors 37,000 plus
98,000.
There is no intercompany adjustment. And bills receivable 35,000 plus 45,000 minus
4,000.
Minus 4,000 of intercompany adjustment. Okay. And then cash and cash equivalents, bank balance 50,000 plus 61,000.
61,000.
Lastly, contingent liability 4,000 plus 6,000 minus
4,000.
Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
You all be able to make the balance sheet on your own?
Yes.
Okay, just 1 minute. Hold on. Just 1 minute. You can take the screenshot of the answer. So that if you don't get the answers, you can verify from that later on. Just give me a minute. Question 18's solution, I don't have right now in the balance sheet with me. I'll do one thing, you all try with the solution. All of you are clear with the solution we discussed just now?
Yes.
In the TYBCOM groups, I'll send you the PDF of the solution. So you can verify.
Okay, sir.
Now in today's video lecture, you are going to cover with which topic?
Profit and loss.
P&L statement is very simple compared to balance sheet. And in exams, it may come in 100% option also in final exams for 15 marks. So it is only going to be over in two lectures, today and tomorrow. Okay? Yep. It doesn't have so many comprehensive working. So watch today's lecture carefully. Tomorrow morning, I'll take live session of P&L statement, one exam questions I take. One of the examination university paper set question I take. Okay?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
And see that all of you watch today's lecture so you are able to participate in tomorrow's live session.
Yes, okay, sir.
Total, there are three questions only done in college which we are going to do in P&L statement. In today's lecture, one question will be covered. And tomorrow's video lecture, two questions will be covered. And in live session, I'll solve one extra question of university papers. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So tomorrow we will wind up with the syllabus. And then Thursday, we will directly meet to discuss the practical MCQ questions. Theory questions, you can directly prepare from MCQ pamphlet. You all have collected the MCQ pamphlet?
Yes, sir.
Answers are already marked in that. So only practical questions, MCQs, I'm going to discuss in the live. Okay, how the calculation is to be done. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, bye everyone. See you tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock.
Bye,
okay, tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock, be prepared with P&L statements workings. Bye.
Bye. Yes, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye.